Well, now that we're in the COVID era, we're all looking for ways to make our writers' notebooks digital. And that's the question I've gotten most recently from a variety of teachers, but Holly Linderman at South Harrison Community Schools in Corydon, Indiana. And Holly, when we're looking at this idea of digital writers' notebooks, of course, they need to understand the software, whether it's Google Docs in Google Classroom, or it's a Word document, your learning management system, whatever it is. So presuming they already know that, just the actual writer's notebook facet, we want to consider some key ingredients. And the first is, if they had a paper-based notebook, then how would you organize the sections of that binder? Because a digital writer's notebook should have multiple folders. We need to have multiple sections. Do we have a separate folder for quick writes versus long extended products? Do you want separate folders for informative writing versus narrative writing versus persuasive or argumentative? How about ELA writing versus content area writing? I don't know, but that's what you need to tell the students. They're looking to you for the organization. So how many folders and what do we name those folders? Then do a couple procedural lessons on how to title documents, because kids notoriously title things in a weird way and then they can't find them. Not to mention, we can't find them when we're looking, searching through their folders for a certain assignment so we can assess it. And so this idea of some kind of a mechanism, just like we teach kids how to head their paper and we're so particular, same thing with how to save documents in their digital writer's notebooks. We also need to teach them how to make digital revisions and digital edits. No longer can we do spider legs. We can't do story surgery. Sticky notes don't have the same meaning that they did before. So how do we add text, remove text? And I know it's just highlight it and delete it, or put your cursor there and type it. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What I mean is, how can they change it so you recognize the revisions or edits? Maybe they do it in a different color, different font color, different highlighter color. Or at the very least, make sure you teach them how to save as. Don't let them save over previous drafts. Always save as, so that they have a second version, third version, fourth version. So however they titled it, keep the same title. Just add a V1, V2, V3, V4. Because how many times have we talked to a kid before who we say, okay, you made some changes. What did your first draft look like? Because it was better. And we want to go back. But if they've deleted it permanently, it's gone. All right. We also want to teach them how to search within their own folders. If everything has a logical name, then you can search for it. It'll be easy to find. We don't have to spend hours opening and closing all these different folders. Just type in a couple keywords from how you titled it. So teach me how to do that, and I'll always be able to find my documents. These are just a couple, just a handful of the procedures I would roll out when first launching a digital writer's notebook this year.